Hey guys, it's Alan5311, and look what I have to show you guys today. I'm going to give you my first impressions on the Kindle Fire. Let's get into it. Alright guys, let's start with the specs on this bad boy. This has a 7-inch multi-touch display with IPS technology and anti-reflective treatment, which I think any tablet should have. It is 16.4 ounces, so it's not that heavy. 8GB internal storage, approximately 6GB available for user content. That's enough for 80 apps, plus 10 movies, or 800 songs, or 6,000 books. It has free cloud storage, and I really like the form factor to this, so let's go over the hardware. This is a very tiny device. It's very small compared to other tablets out there like the iPad. So let's look at the hardware to this device. On the bottom, you have a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. You have your power supply. You have your actual power button to turn on the device on the bottom, which most tablets, it's on the top. And if you look on the top, we have two stereo speakers. So very nice sound quality, and on these sides we have nothing. So this device, I like it. I like that I can hold it in one hand. It's very portable. I can take it with me basically anywhere. It'll fit into my bag. Alright, so this carousel right here is going to show you all your recent apps that you've opened up. So, and it'll show you web pages too, as you can see right here. Alright, behind that, there's a web page that I opened up. So any web page you open up, it'll show up in the carousel. So if you're looking at some things that you don't want other people seeing, specifically porn, maybe you should not get the Kindle. Anyways, guys, yeah, so I'll show you everything you've opened up. Down here is your favorites you can add to that. And from the other videos I looked up on YouTube about the Kindle Fire, they, including myself, cannot find a way to remove anything from the little carousel up here. So everything you open up will show up right here. And as I was saying, as I was saying, this is your favorites. You can add to it. It does get bigger once you add more and more apps. Now let's look up the categories up here. You have newsstand. And this looks exactly like the iOS newsstand app, just like a bookcase, and you can download some magazines and stuff from the store, and I am not connected to the internet. And you can go to the store and buy magazines. Simple as that. Just like the iOS application that we all know about. Books. So this is books you can buy, many different books you can buy. You know, that'd be one of the top reasons you would get the Kindle. Music. And you can buy different music. So this is turning into an all-in-one tablet. You can do everything on here. Video. Different videos. You have docs, which I'm guessing is documents. And you have your applications. So this is all your applications. You can add them to your favorites. As I showed you earlier, you can download applications. So let's go into the store. And the Kindle Fire is said to be running Android, but the App Store is Amazon's own thing. It's not the Android marketplace. So, many apps where you can download. Many apps that you can download. Angry Birds, anyone? Alright, so, many different apps you can download, and then you have the web. So, this is the browser. It is very fast, I might say. And another thing I'd like to add is I do like the Android keyboard, like, better than the iPad keyboard. Let's head on over to an actual site. Alright, so I've headed over to Amazon.com. Now let's test out pinch to zoom. And might I say it's not as clean as I would like it to be. And let's rotation. And I'm going to compare this to iOS with this clean scrolling, clean pinch to zoom, and its fantastic rotation animations, as I say. This is blocky, you know, blocky, regular blocky Android. Kindle Fire. So it's definitely a good browser, but it's just not the best. I just don't find it superior to any other browser. And there go your five categories. Not five. Jeez. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so there go your seven categories up top. Alright, so let's go into settings. If you click on that little gear right there, you have settings, which you can rotation lock this. So this is unlock and I can lock it. You can change the volume in settings. You can change the brightness. The Wi-Fi, and you can just sync it. And if you click on more, it will go to your full settings with everything for your account settings, sounds, display, security, applications, date and time, wireless network, Kindle keyboard device, legal notice, and terms of use. So guys, I'm going to give you my first impression on this finally. So I must say this is a pretty solid device. It's very small, which I like about it. It's very portable. I can take it with me. I can put it in my bag, and I'm pretty sure it will fit in my bag. I don't have to worry about that. And let's compare it to the iPad. So I have my iPad right here. Okay guys, I'm going to show you some specs from the iPad 2 just to see how it compares to the Kindle Fire. It's 8.50 inches tall, 7.31 inches width-wise, and it's 1.33 pounds. In contrast to the Kindle, 14.6, I think, ounces. You can get Wi-Fi, you can get a Wi-Fi model, 3G model. For this, it only comes in one model, which is the Wi-Fi model. This is a 9.7 inch display. Alright, so that is the specs for the Apple iPad 2. Let me actually compare the two. So this is the Kindle Fire right here. This is the Apple iPad 2. Let's sit one on top of the other. As you can tell, the Kindle Fire is much smaller than the Apple iPad 2. The Apple iPad 2 is much thinner than the Kindle Fire. Or if you're on a low budget and you don't need anything too extravagant, too big, go with the Kindle Fire. You can download apps, movies, books, basically anything, and it's still a great device. It's small, it's portable, and it's low in cost compared to other tablets out there in the market. Anyways, guys. This was Alan5311. This was my first impression, so sorry if I did not cover every single little thing. And thank you guys for watching. Subscribe to me if you haven't. It's free. Know when I post new videos. And until then, guys, take care.